What I've realized over the years is that small distinctions can make a huge difference in terms of your results with what we call the law of attraction. And I'm going to share with you why there is no attraction in this video, why the law of attraction actually doesn't even exist, right? There is no such thing as the law of attraction, and what you should be doing instead and understanding this concept that you are the creator. Recently, Rhonda Byrne came out with a new book called The Greatest Secret. And she was the originator of the movie The Secret and the film The Secret. And in many of her teachings, she has forgotten to teach one very powerful concept, that you're not attracting anything at all. Now, before we continue here, I really appreciate Rhonda Byrne for all of her teachings and the things that she's putting out into the world. It's really helping us discover more about ourselves, what we're capable of, and she radically changed my life. Just from watching the movie The Secret, it changed the direction of my life completely. And so this video, my intention is not to put down Rhonda or anything like that, but when it comes to spirituality and the law of attraction and creating your reality, we need to understand that we are not necessarily manifesting anything and we're not attracting something into our lives. We are the creators of our reality, and Neville Goddard says basically our imagination is God. We are pure awareness and everyone has consciousness. And so we have to understand that every individual on this planet has this consciousness. And so we're all consciousness, and consciousness is what I like to call God, or you can call it the universe, whatever name or label you want to put on it. And this consciousness can become aware of ourselves. This consciousness can become aware of our emotions, can become aware of our thoughts. And that's what a lot of this book is actually about. It's becoming aware that you are consciousness, that you are awareness. And one of the distinctions that I want to bring to your awareness here today is that you are the center of it all. Everything in your external reality is a reflection of you. Because if you define someone as very good looking, that's your own reality, that's your own perspective, right? Another person might see that person and think that person is ugly, for example, right? Or might not be attracted to that person. A lot of money for one person is different for another person. For example, someone like, Oprah Winfrey or Tony Robbins, you know, $1 million is a lot of money, but to them, it's like, you know, that's like a small percentage of my income, you know? And so some of these people make that kind of money in a day. And so to them, it's a small amount. So when it comes to making like $10, for example, for them, it takes like a millisecond or probably less than that to make that amount of money. So what we're experiencing is a projection of our subconscious mind. And what I mean by that is your subconscious mind is like a big recorder. You know, like when you go to the cinemas and you got the big projector at the back and it's playing the film, it's doing the reel, right? It's spinning around, right? And it's projecting that on the screen. That's how your subconscious mind works. Whatever your subconscious mind is programmed to see and experience is basically what you're going to see and experience. So we experience in our reality our subconscious programs. But not only that, we actually experience the programs of other people's subconscious minds as well. And so what we have to do is begin getting out of harmony with those that we don't want to experience and the things that we don't want to experience in our lives, and get in harmony with the things that we want to experience and the people that we want to experience in our lives. Now, there was a time in my life where I kept on attracting narcissistic people. I just kept on attracting these people into my life. And that's because it was a reflection of who I was. Not that I'm narcissistic, but it was a reflection of who I was in terms of being an empath and attracting people who would take advantage of me. And so what I developed is the vibrational frequencies, the emotions, the states of I am someone that has boundaries. I am someone that has red flags. I don't accept these kinds of people into my life. And as I began doing that, these people no longer show up in my life anymore because I've become unfuckable with. And so my energy resonates, I'm unfuckable with. And so a narcissist knows they can't fuck with me, right? So that's what we want to begin to realize. If you want to make more money in your life, you have to become the reflection of making more money. You have to assume the position that you want to be in. And this is called the law of assumption. The law of assumption basically implies that you are the being that is automatically creating the reality that you want. You assume the position. You become the person who is confident. You start being it in the here and in the now. And as you begin to do that, whatever represents that state, let's say it's confidence, people will start complimenting you. People will start treating you differently. Maybe you'll get a raise. Maybe you'll move up the career ladder. Maybe you'll attract your dream life partner. Just from changing who you are and the state and assuming the person that you would prefer to be. The law of assumption stems from Neville Goddard's teachings. And basically what he's saying is, you need to know what you want to create, but who do I need to be in order to get there? So the greatest secret, in my opinion, is not necessarily that it's the law of attraction and you're putting things into your life, it's the law of reflection or the law of assumption, meaning you are a reflection of your external reality. You might be asking, well, how comes there's wars in the world? How comes there's poverty? How comes there's all this stuff? That is a reflection of other people's subconscious minds. Maybe you don't resonate with that. Maybe you don't like that about the world, but you've got to change how you feel about it. Otherwise, you're going to continue seeing it and experiencing and being triggered by it. And that can cause one of two things. You can get paralyzed by these things and be at the detriment of your own being and just feeling like, why is this happening in the world? Or you can take action on it based on pain, all right? Meaning you're gonna do something about it. You're gonna take action and do something. Maybe go give to charity or help people out or whatever it is. Now, what I've realized is that these two things are both stemming from lack. And don't get me wrong here, I think pain is a very good motivator, but also I think we need to also have that abundant perspective as well. And knowing that I am a reflection of my reality. When I change myself, the world will change around me. And so maybe a better thing to do, rather than feeling pain and having that put you into action, maybe feeling abundant and knowing that you can change the world and make a huge difference. So what really stops the law of attraction is our subconscious programs. Our subconscious programs is a reflection of what we see in the external world. So when something's not showing up in your life, when you're not manifesting your dream life partner, when you're not manifesting love, when you're not manifesting more money in your life, when you're not manifesting more success into your life, when you're not manifesting your twin flame, when you're not manifesting, you know, the car that you want or whatever it is that you want, more harmony, love, and peace into your life, that's a reflection of what's going on within. There's blocks that are stopping you from getting there. And right now, I'm actually offering a free energy reading and a manifestation diagnosis. And that's completely free. And you can go ahead and claim that in the link in the description. And what's going to happen is I'm going to record a short video just for you to basically find out what's stopping you from reaching that next level in your business, in your life, in your career, in your relationships, and provide you with an energy reading to see where you're resonating at so you can begin manifesting what you want into your life. If you want to go ahead and do that, send us a message on WhatsApp at whatsappgavin.com, or you can go ahead and click the link in the description to get your free energy reading. And check out this video over here. It's about this book, The Greatest Secret by Rhonda Byrne. I reviewed the book. And remember to keep learning, keep growing, keep expanding, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.